What's going on, guys? So today we're going to be working on the 2020 S1000. We're going to be installing this right here. I have all these other goodies, but today our main focus is on this. I'm going to go ahead and go through all the steps I went through to install this. Hopefully no mistakes, but if there is mistakes, we're going to correct them. Let's go ahead and get into it. So the first thing we did, we took off the top fairing and then the side fairings. Then we took off the tank. We can go ahead and look at the tank over here. We got the tank, the top piece on top of the tank, these two side fairings, and this right here was the chain guard. Then after that, I went ahead and removed the battery. Very easy. The reason we're taking the tank off is because we have to go ahead and disconnect some wires all up in here, and also when we do the relocating, we have to run some wires through there anyways, so it'll be a lot easier for us to just get up in there overall. It's just better to do so you don't run into a more difficult problem than you already have. So that's gonna help out a lot, removing the tank.
I made a mark right here. If you get down a little bit, you can see this blue mark. Just in case if we gotta recollaborate it or something like that, I know where it was at. I used this piece of cardboard right here. Just set it in here. I got that mark in there. So after that's done, I used a 10 millimeter wrench. I already loosened it up, so it's just hanging on there by a couple threads. And then once that's removed, we can just have that up here and throw a little zip tie on it to hold it back for us, just like that. And also, you want to remove this wire that's in here, this black wire. Let's see if you can see that right here. Move it from the clip that's on there.
So the next thing you want to do is go ahead and get you a T55 bit. Then you want to get it on your impact or whatever you got.
Down in here. Just want to, oh shit.
I'm pretty sure on the other side, I'm gonna have to hit it out. Got some tension on it. Just like that. So now that you got your thick screw out, your shock should be loose right here. You can see that. That's a loose shock right there. So what I'm gonna be doing is, right here, every time I do this, it's lifting up the bike. So you can go ahead and take a look in here. This bolt right here with the yellow paint on it, as you can see, when I'm, every time I lift it up, that bolt is coming closer to us, and it's going to give us an easier clearance to be able to unscrew that.
A few minutes later.
Alright, so what I had to use was a socket wrench and a T55 Torx bit. I had to get into right here, take this bolt out. You guys can take a look at that. It was really tight, so what I had to do was I had to get that socket wrench up in there, and then I had to get this right here. It's a little tube, aluminum tube or steel tube, and I had to put it on the wrench to get some more leverage on it, just because it was so tight. And when you guys are doing this, just be careful for this piece and anything else in the way, because it's a very tight space in there to work with. So now that I got it loose, I'm gonna go ahead and use this. I got this little twisted adapter right here. I'm gonna get it on this bolt in here. Got that in there. So don't pull it out, don't unloosen it too much, because you're gonna run into the problem I did right here, which is now it's wedged against that. So I gotta take it back in a little bit and probably unhand tighten it or get the wrench again. But now that we got it very loose in here, this bolt in here, you can get it out only so much with the tools. So what you're gonna need to do is, we had to lower the bike a little bit, drop it down, and play with the shock right here.
You gotta release, do that to release the tension, and then you can unscrew the bolt by hand as long as you keep playing with it. And then there's a sweet spot inside of there that will let you unscrew the bolt. All right, so now with that, we got this top one loose. Then we're gonna go ahead and get this bottom one out. Where did it go? Right here. This is the OEM link. We're gonna be reusing these right here, so we'll be taking those out, greasing them up, and put them in the new one. Use some wheel bearing grease, so make sure they're all lubed up. Let's go ahead and get to it. I'm taking the spacers out of the OEM links. You just gotta put a little bit of pressure on them and they start sliding out, but it's... There goes that first one. Maybe I shouldn't bang them like that. And here goes the second one, sliding out. Right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and make this into, right now it's configuration one. I'm gonna switch it to the configuration two, because I'm gonna get this bike as low as I can with the stock shock in it, which means we need to cut out underneath right here, underneath this tray. We're gonna need to move this battery regulator and cut out a little slot to be able to let this shock be able to go up a little bit more in there. So this is how the configuration one is. What you need to do is flip this one around, flip this one around. And this is a left-hand thread, so righty-tighty is actually lefty-loosey. And lefty-loosey is righty-tighty. You want to go ahead and screw those all the way in. Now that we got it like that, we're going to go ahead and put some of this grease on this right here. Side of here. Stick that one in there. Get this one. Get that all lubed up. That one in there. Clean it all off. So with the configuration two, we have to, when we lower it, this shock is gonna be coming up. And if you can see under here, we have to move the voltage regulator and these two connectors. I already unplugged the connectors. I just have this barely coming off too. So when we get that out, we're gonna have to relocate it to somewhere else. Once we got that, then we'll bring the bike down. This can come out. You don't need that. Got that out. And now we'll come back down here. We're gonna have to cut into this right here to let this shock be able to come up in here more. Because if that voltage regulator would have still been there, it would have been banging into it. But we're going with configuration two, which means we're gonna have to just Dremel out a little rectangle in here. So the top of this shock will be able to go inside of there. I got my Dremel right here. I have my cutoff wheel, little sand, rough sander, whatever. Before you start cutting, you need to make sure that this right here, these wires are out of the way, because if you cut that, that's gonna cause some pretty bad damage and you're gonna end up spending more than you want to on your project. And I don't think anybody wants that. So make sure the wires are out of the way before you start cutting underneath here. So I did what I could. I didn't have any safety glasses here in the shop, so I had to throw my helmet on because my eyes, so eye protection is first. But you can go ahead and look in there and see it's quite a big gap right there that we need to be able to let this shock go in there freely. The wires that were down underneath here, what I did was I pulled through right here. I had to cut a little zip tie that was on here. I had to cut that off. And then I pulled this through, the gray one and the black one through. And now we have to relocate them inside of here. What you are going to be doing is taking this fuse and this extra fuse, there's more fuses in here. You're gonna be moving them over to the side while we put this in here and hook them up. This was in here holding the battery from sliding around, but you don't need that anymore because that's what these little fuses are gonna be doing. They're gonna be leaning against this and holding the battery around from sliding. So when we get that set up in there, I'll show you what it looks like. So this is the setup we have right here. We have the fuses up here. Can you see that? Right up in there, we have the fuses sitting in there from protecting the battery from sliding forward. We haven't hooked the battery up just yet, but we had to kind of just shove it down in there. This is the best spot for it right now. There's not another spot to do it at the moment, but when there is, I'm gonna try to make a video for you guys. So now that this is all good to go and the seat will fit down on that, let's go ahead and install the link, lowering link. So we got the link how we want it and we're going to install it, but instead of putting the Loctite, by the way, if this is your final setup and this is the way you're going to have it, you need to put some Loctite on it. We did put some in here on the thread. I don't know if you can see it back in there. It's on that back thread and then on that top thread, we got some Loctite in there. So what I'm going to do is, get on the other side for me and lift up the shot like you can see in here. That top one facing the right way. I'm getting that in there hand tight. The top one in there. As much as I can tighten it with my hand. Now, this bottom one. Yeah, so what I have to do is drop it down and this lines up right with it. So you're gonna want 73.75 foot-pounds of torque on these screws for that holds the link in. And now I'm putting some Loctite down here that holds the shock up. What we can do is line these up right here. Just stick this bolt in here, it goes in there. You can feel it right there. Get that hand tight down in here. Just wanna, so a tip when you guys are adjusting the bike, you need to be moving this up and down at the same time as when you're twisting this right here, this piece, the actual link itself. As you're lifting the bike up or down, you have to do it at the same time. And if you don't have one of these little jacks down here, I'd recommend buying one. I got it on Amazon, I think for like 80 bucks. I slapped some Brock stickers on it. Makes it look way better, but I'd really recommend getting one of these. And yeah, that's just a tip right there for you guys. And we can show you how low we actually got it. You can see how close the actual shock is to the top of that pan down there. It's pretty close, I'd say about half an inch. Maybe, yeah, I think about half an inch.
About
half an inch. We could go lower if we wanted to, but that feels nice for my liking. My legs feel good on it. I can tell the difference. So the next thing we're gonna do is probably lower the front, which is another video. Put the Brox kickstand on there. Hear this bad boy. And that'll be the next video for you guys. Thank you for watching and subscribe. Can I survive with this mentality?